Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. We all know that for years now, NASA's been hunting for any evidence of life on other planets other than our Mother Earth. With this in mind, NASA's gone to some great lengths to find that evidence, sending a bunch of satellites out there to explore other planets. Not only that, but the agency has even launched a couple of rovers to the Martian surface to try and experiment on the surface and find any evidence that might suggest that life once existed or could exist on the planet. However, the red planet is not the only body in the solar system that NASA has its eyes on, trying to find evidence of life. NASA is now thinking of sending more rovers to Saturn and Jupiter, but not the planets. On two moons in particular, NASA hopes to find evidence of life. These are Europa, one of Jupiter's moons, and Enceladus, one of Saturn's moons. But why are these two moons of the greatest interest to the agency? Why is it that they're even planning to launch some sort of swimming robot to explore the moon? Make sure you watch to the end to find out why all these plans are there. Before we continue, just take a moment to smash that like button and subscribe to Liftoff for nothing but the latest news on Elon Musk, Tesla, SpaceX, science, technology, and so much more. And with that, let's find out more about these plans. The main reason for these plans and interest is the fact that these two satellites are covered with nothing but ice. Not only are these planets covered in ice, but the very thick layer of ice is several kilometers deep from the surface. According to scientists, there could be some pretty enormous oceans of liquid water under this thick layer of ice that coats the satellites. Because of this, there is only speculation about strange sea creatures swimming underneath the thick layers of ice. Most recently, there was a concept design that proposed a novel solution to the problem of the thick ice sheets covering the satellites. A new idea has been brought forward by Ethan Shaler, a robotics mechanical engineer at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. According to Shaler, he can build some sort of robotic swimmer, which he called Sensing with Independent Micro Swimmers, or SWIM. This project was nearly awarded $600,000 by NASA to make it happen. According to Shaler's concept, dozens of mobile phone-sized swimming probes can be released onto the surface of Europa, and once they get to the surface, they can work their way below the thick layer of ice, exploring the underworld of the satellite. However, all this raises some questions. How will they manage to penetrate the thick layer of ice to reach the liquid part of the ocean? They will make use of a cryobot. This is just a robot that has the capability to penetrate the water ice. It mostly makes use of heat, which melts the ice, giving it a path downwards. This cryobot to be used on the ice surfaces would have a narrow ice-melting probe, and this is where the swimming probes would be placed. The narrow probe will then work to melt the ice and reach the ocean, creating a path for the swimming probes. And once they both get to the ocean, the cryobot would release the swimming probes and they would immediately begin gathering data. If this entire idea were to be developed into something that is actually practical, then we might not only see the probes sent to Europa, but they would also be sent to Enceladus. This could actually be the next breakthrough that the agency requires to find evidence of other life apart from that on Earth. NASA's main goal is to make this happen by 2030. However, the thick layer of ice is not the only reason that NASA seems so interested in the two satellites. For Enceladus, it has been said that there is more to the ice water. According to a study that was done on the planet about a year ago, it was discovered that there is something producing methane on Enceladus. Not only that, but it's coming from the subsurface oceans. In the science world, methane could only be a possible indication of life. According to Charlie Wood, who discussed these results, the analysis suggested that the methane was being produced in a similar way to methanogenic microbes in the oceans here on Earth. But could this really indicate proof of life on the planet? The initial detection of methane on this moon was from analyzed data collected by the Cassini spacecraft. This spacecraft managed to make several close flybys of this moon. As it was going about its mission, it flew right through water vapor plumes that were erupting through the cracks at Enceladus' south pole. The water vapor from these plumes came from the ocean deep below the icy surface. In addition to that, Cassini also found some ice particles, salts, hydrogen, and organic molecules in the plumes. All these are signs of an ocean that was quite similar to that of Earth's oceans when it comes to composition. Furthermore, there was also evidence for hydrothermal vents on Enceladus' seafloor, which is similar to those that support methanogens here in our Earth's oceans. But what could be producing all this methane on the icy moon? The large amounts of methane being produced here are quite difficult to explain. Even if it were the chemical process that could be capable of producing methane on Enceladus, serpentinization, it's not possible to produce that much methane as was observed. So what could it be? According to Antonin Affholder, lead authority of the study, methanogens are able to explain the amount of methane. Methanogens are microbial life forms that eat hydrogen and carbon dioxide as they produce methane as a byproduct. Here on Earth, these methanogens are found at deep-sea hydrothermal vents, such as the ones that are speculated to exist on Enceladus' surface. This might be a good enough reason to prove that life exists on this moon. But could it really? Scientists are not clear whether the process producing this methane are biological or non-biological. They've tried to come up with all possible scenarios where methane could be produced in the Enceladus ocean. It could be non-biological, as seen in serpentinization. In this process, hot water interacts with minerals in the rocks to create hydrogen. Though some chemical reactions to this hydrogen is then combined with carbon dioxide, giving off methane. In addition to the methane coming from methanogens, this could also be a reason. But to find out more, we might have to wait to see until these swimmer bots are sent. As for Europa, NASA has been planning a mission to the Jupiter moon for years now. They're currently working on a probe that they call the Europa Clipper, which is scheduled for launch sometime in 2024. Once the Clipper arrives in Jupiter's orbit, it'll start making dozens of flybys of Europa as it characterizes the moon's oceans. In addition to that, it will also be studying the icy surface in detail, among other tasks. This surface reconnaissance performed by the Clipper will pave the way for a future Europa lander, which NASA was directed to start developing by Congress. The lander, which is just a concept at the moment, would proceed to dig down and hunt for any signs of life about 4 inches beneath the European surface. This is with the theory that any biomolecules residing at these depths would automatically be shielded from some damaging radiation by the overlying thick layer of ice. This theory came after it was discovered that Europa is found within Jupiter's radiation belt, meaning that the moon's surface receives quite a lot of radiation. The ultimate source of most of these biomolecules, if they do exist, could most likely come from Europa's vast ocean, which is said to contain twice as much water as all of Earth's seas combined. And because of this, scientists have been planning how they will launch some sort of life-hunting robots down on the surface. Initially, there were opinions about launching some sort of swimming squid bot to explore the surface, but it was never really decided. With the swimming bots back in the picture, the agency might also decide to take a look at Europa and try to find out whether it could also contain life on it. These cell phone-sized robots could be the only solution at the moment, and the entire project is being funded by NASA. According to some of the early stage decisions, it's speculated that microbots measure about 5 inches long and 3 to 5 cubic inches in volume. They would also be outfitted with their own propulsion systems and onboard sensors for temperature, salinity, acidity, and pressure. The bots would also contain chemical sensors that would be used to monitor biomarkers or signs of life. But this would be in the second phase. If all goes according to plan, we might see these bots launched in 2024. Do you think the agency will meet this target? Feel free to let us know in the comment section below. Also, before you go, make sure that you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for nothing but the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, technology, and so much more. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.